England. This is Vansi Shah, Assistant Professor in the Department of Pharmacology from LG Institute of Pharmacy. I welcome you all to this MOOC lecture video series, an initiative taken by LG Institute of Pharmacy. So today's our discussion topic will be about anti-rheumatic drugs. First of all, what is rheumatoid arthritis? So rheumatoid arthritis, it is an autoimmune disease which causes proliferation of synovial membrane. It involves at least three joints and it causes morning stiffness for about 1 hour or more, and the pain induced due to rheumatoid arthritis is extreme. Now, various anti-rheumatoid drugs. So first, that is disease modifying anti-rheumatoid drugs, that is DMARDs, that is disease modifying anti-rheumatoid drugs. In that, first, that is non-biological drugs, that is various immunosuppressants. Example are methotrexate, azathioprine, cyclosporine. Then next, that is sulfasalazine, chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine, and leflunomide. Then biological agents, in that TNF alpha inhibitors, that is etanercept, infliximab, adalimumab, and second, that is interleukin 1 antagonist, that is enakinakra. Others, that is rituximab and abatacept. Then other adjuvant drugs used are corticosteroids, prednisolone, and others. So first, that is methotrexate. The mechanism of action is that it inhibits dihydrofolate reductase enzyme, which inhibits the synthesis of tetrahydrofluorate, which causes inhibition in the synthesis of TNF-alpha and other cytokines, which inhibit inflammatory reactions. Methotrexate, it also inhibits DNA synthesis, chemotaxis, and cell-mediated immune reaction. The pharmacokinetics of this is that induction dose, that is oral dose, is about 7.5 to 15 milligram per week. Onset is 4 to 6 weeks. Then this DMARD is of first choice and standard treatment for most patients. It is not recommended in renal patients. Uses, that is certain type of cancer, rheumatoid arthritis, and psoriasis. The side effect of this methotrexate is that oral ulcer, GI upset, then prolonged use may cause liver damage, that is it can lead to liver cirrhosis, increased risk of infection. The contraindication is during pregnancy, breastfeeding, liver disease, active infection, leukopenia, and peptic ulcer. Next drug, that is azathioprine. So mechanism of action is that azathioprine, it is getting converted into 6-mercaptopurine by the enzyme thiopurine thiomethyl transferase, that is TPMT, which inhibit purine synthesis, which causes less DNA and RNA synthesis, which causes less WBC, and which causes immunosuppression. So it selectively affects differentiation and functions of T cells and natural killer cells and inhibits inflammation. So the note for the azathioprine is that remission is produced in smaller number of patients, so it is less commonly used. It has steroid sparing effect, so less dose of steroid needed, and it is not combined with methotrexate. The next, that is sulfasalazine. So its mechanism of action is that it is composed of sulfapyridine and 5-aminosalicylic acid. 5-aminosalicylic acid, it exerts anti-inflammatory effect, and it is used in ulcerative colitis. It acts through inhibition of COX and inhibition of chemotaxis and its potent antioxidant activity. The pharmacokinetics of sulfasalazine is that it splits off in the colon by bacterial action and absorbs systematically. Dose of this sulfasalazine is that it is given 1 to 3 gram per day. It is divided into 2 to 3 doses. The adverse effects are neutropenia, thrombocytopenia, and hepatitis. And uses, that is, it is a second line of drug for milder or in combination with methotrexate. Then the next, that is chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine. Actually, chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine, it is anti-malarial drug, but It is found to induce remission in 50% patients and but take 3 to 6 months. Mechanism of this hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine, apart from its anti-malarial action, is that it inhibits interleukin-1 production, which inhibits beta lymphocyte activity, which inhibits antibody synthesis, and it also possesses lysosomal stabilization property. That is why it is used in rheumatoid arthritis. The adverse effect of it, it accumulates in the tissue like corneal deposit and retinal damage, so which causes toxicity. Then the next adverse effects observed, that is rashes, gray hair, then inflammatory bowel syndrome, myopathy and neuropathy. Uses, that is it is used when fewer joints are affected or in combination with methotrexate or sulfasalazine. The next drug, that is leflunomide. Leflunomide, it is having similar efficacy to that methotrexate. Onset is faster, that is 4 weeks. Mechanism of action is that it is getting converted into active metabolite, which inhibits dihydroorate dehydrogenase and pyrimidine synthesis in actively dividing cells, which inhibit the differentiation of leukocytes. Antibody production by beta cells, they are also depressed. Pharmacokinetics, that is, it is having longer half-life, that is about 2 to 3 weeks. Loading dose of 100 mg daily for 3 doses, followed by 20 mg daily. Adverse effect, that is diarrhea, headache, nausea, rashes, loss of hair, thrombocytopenia, leukopenia, increased risk of infection or hepatotoxicity. Then it is contraindicated in children pregnant during pregnancy and in lactating mothers. It is used as an alternative or as an additive agent to methotrexate, and it is this combination, but this combination is mostly hepatotoxic. The next, that is biological DMARDs, that is DMARDs, right? It is effective in rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory bowel disease, psoriasis and scleroedema. It produces prominent adverse effects. It is expensive. The response is quicker than other non-biologicals. It is used as a reserve drug for severe refractory disease. The next, that is TNF-alpha inhibitors. So, mechanism of action of TNF-alpha inhibitor is that TNF-alpha receptor protein or antibody neutralize TNF-alpha, which reduce TNF-alpha receptor activity, which is present on the surface of T cells and macrophages, which inhibit macrophage and T cell function. TNF-alpha inhibitors, they are used as monotherapy, but generally added to methotrexate when methotrexate is not adequate. The adverse effects are: it causes susceptibility to opportunistic infections including TB, pneumocystis, pneumonia. The next, that is etanercept, that is recombinant fusion protein of TNF receptor and Fc portion of human immunoglobulin. It is given as subcutaneously only and it is given weekly. It causes pain, redness, itching, swelling. Then next, that is infliximab and adalimumab. It is monoclonal antibody. It is used in combination with methotrexate to improve the response and decrease antibody formation. Infliximab, it is given by intravenous infusion, while adalimumab, it is given as subcutaneously. Then interleukin-1 antagonist. So interleukin-1 antagonists, they are less effective as compared to that of TNF-alpha inhibitor. The interleukin-1 antagonists are Enoknara, that is interleukin-1 receptor antagonist, then abatacept, that is inhibit T cell activation, and rituximab, that is a monoclonal antibody that destroys and depletes beta cells. The next, that is corticosteroids. So systemic corticosteroids, that is prednisolone, then intra-articular injection given, that is triamcinolone and methylprednisolone. So it has potent anti-inflammatory and immunosuppressive activity. They do not arrest rheumatoid process, but the process of joint destruction is slowed down. Low dose of steroid with NSAID for chronic period, it is prescribed, and higher dose for shorter period, it is prescribed. In case of single joint involvement, intra-articular injection, that is preferred. These are the frequently asked questions regarding this topic. And these are the references. For more such videos, please like, share and subscribe our official YouTube channel Pharma Ignite and press bell icon for more such notifications. Thank you.